Hello students, today we are going to learn algebraic identities, chapter number 9, algebraic expressions and identities, class 8. So let's understand the meaning of algebraic identities. So here it's a figure of balance. Now observe, this balance is empty, that is there is nothing in any plate. So they are in the same level. What will happen when we put some apples in the left hand side plate? Yes, the plate which has the apples goes downside, but the plate which has no apples, that is empty, goes upside. That meaning left hand side plate is heavier and the right hand side plate is lighter. Now when we keep some apples on the right hand side plates also, so what will happen? It will go a little bit down as compared to its previous position. Then again when we keep on putting apples in the right hand side plate till we get the both plates are in same level. So here we observe that both the plates are having the same weight as they are in same straight line. Observe the previous figure when both the plates of the weight are balance are empty. In this scenario, the plates are in a straight line and we can say both are in same level. Also in this, when plates are filled with the weight, that equal weights are there, in this situation also both the plates are in same level. So we can conclude that when the balance, both the plates are empty, the left hand side plate is equal to right hand side plate. Similarly, when plates containing weight, that is equal weight, in this also left hand side plate and right hand side plates are also equal. So this we can say left hand side is equals to right hand side. Now can we relate this left hand side and right hand side with mathematics or any? Can we relate? Yes, it is an equation where the left hand sides and right hand sides are equal. Now any algebraic expression we write equals to sign and again the second algebraic expression, that is between the two algebraic expression when we put the equal to sign, so the algebraic expression become an equation. So equation is nothing but an equality. The word equality shows the equal to sign there. So we can say an equation is an equality. Now in the earlier classes also we learned this equation as we put the values for x, y and z variables and we get that the value in the left hand side is equal to the right hand side. So the meaning here we get that an equation is a condition on variable. That means for any particular value of the variable, equation satisfies, that is both the sides of the equations are equal for the particular value of the variable. So that value of the variable is known as the solution of the equation. Now here some examples of equation 2x plus 3y is equal to 2 and 4a minus 3 is equal to 0, where in both the equations 2x plus 3y and 4a minus 3, these two are the left hand side of the equations and 2 also the zero are the right hand side of equation. Now when we put the values of x and y, when we put the values of x and y and get the left hand side is equal to 2 after solving the value x and y, we get the value of left hand side is 2. So we can say right hand side is also 2 and left hand side is also 2. So this left hand side is equals to right hand side. So this is an equation. 4a minus 3 is equals to 0. For particular value of a, the left hand side becomes 0. So that particular value of a is known as the solution of the equation, for which this equation both the sides equal. Now let's take example x plus y is equals to y plus x. This is an equation. Yes, it is an equation. X plus y and y plus x, these two expressions are written with the equal to sign in between them. So we can say this x plus y is equals to y plus x is an equation. And now what will happen when we put the value x and y both equals to 1? So let's take the left hand side of the equation. X plus y will become 1 plus 1 and it is equals to 2. For value of y plus x, again we put y and x both are equals 1. So 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. Now here we observe that x plus y as well as y plus x both are equal, that is 2. Now let's take another values for these variables. Put x is equals to 1 and y is equals to minus 2 here. So what will happen for x plus y? X, that is 1, and y is minus 2. So x plus y becomes 1 plus minus 2 and it is equals to 1 minus 2, and we get x plus y is minus 1. Now solve for right hand side y plus x, that is minus 2 plus 1 and it is equals to minus 1. So here in this situation also we can say y plus x and x plus y both are same, minus 1. So here we can say x plus y is equals to y plus x is an equation which is satisfies for all values of x and y, that is left hand side and right hand sides are equal. Now let's take one more example so it will easy to get the idea that values of variable which satisfies, that for all values of variable satisfies the equation. So let's take an example. PQ is equals to under root PQ. Now here when we put P and Q both equals to 1, so left hand side PQ is 1 into 1, that is 1, and right hand side under root PQ is under root 1 into 1, that is a square root of 1, and it is equals to 1. Now here again we observe that PQ and under root PQ, both the left hand side and right hand side are equals to 1. Now put the values other than 1, that is 2 and 3. Now what will the answer for PQ is 2 into 3, that is 6. This is the left hand side, and the right hand side square root of PQ, that is equals to 2 in square root of 2 into 3, that is under root 6. Here this PQ left hand side and the right hand side under root PQ, here in this situation when P is 2 and Q is 3 are not same. One is giving left hand side is 6, whereas the right hand side is a square root of 6. Both are not equal. So in this second example, for all values of P and Q, this equation PQ is equals to square root PQ not satisfied. But in the example number 1, x plus y is equals to y plus x, for all values of variable x and y, equation is satisfies. Now meaning of equation is satisfies, that means left hand side and right hand side are equal. Any value we put, we get left hand side and right hand sides are equal. So here we can say in the second example, right hand side is not equal to left hand side. on the basis of this concept, on the basis of these two examples, we can get an equation which is satisfies for all values of variable is known as the identity, or it is an algebraic identity. So any equation which is true or which is satisfy for all values of variable is the identity. Any numerical value we put the variable, we get both the sides are equal. So that equation becomes an identity. So here are some standard identities. First identity is a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Second is a minus b whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. And third is a plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. Now here you can check for any value of a and b in all these three equations. Put the values of a and b, any values of a and b, you will get left hand side and right hand side are equal. So that's why these equations are known as identities and it is called standard identities. Now these three are also known as the basic identities. So these are the basic identities. Other than these, one identity also is there that says x plus a into x plus b, that is equals to x square plus a plus bx plus ab. This also used, and when you put any value for x, a and b, all the three variables, you will get left hand side and the right hand side are same. So remember, any equation which is satisfied for all values of variable is known as algebraic identities, and these three are the basic identities. That means we have the four identities and these are satisfies. These equations are satisfies for any value of the variable. That's why they are known as the identities. So I hope you understand the concept of algebraic identities, or simply we can say identities.